Hi friends, I am Jairam Reddy, formerly professor of physics and vice chancellor Sri Venkateswara University. Last time I appeared in October 2020. There has been a gap of 7 months due to the COVID pandemic. Tomorrow, June 5th, is a World Environment Day. So I thought, as an environmental enthusiast, to say a few words on one of the important topics, that is worrying the energy and climate scientists. The COVID-19 crisis has caused more disruption globally than any other event in recent history. It is leaving wounds that will last for years to come. But whether this disruption ultimately helps or hampers efforts to reach international energy and climate goals will depend upon how governments respond to the challenges of the day. One of the important goals from the climate change point of view is acceleration of clean energy transitions from fossil fuels. You know very well, fossil fuels has been the conventional fuels the world over was using, which are now slowly replaced by the clean energy sources. The International Energy Agency has been examining this issue of achieving net zero emissions by 2050 from different perspectives over the last 2 years. This is in the context of 2015 Paris Agreement, where all the world countries pledged to cut carbon emissions voluntarily so as to restrict the rise in global average temperature below 2 degrees centigrade. And preferably 1.5 degrees centigrade by 2100, that means the end of this century. What are the actions IEA, International Energy Agency, has done? One, in 2019, IEA provided an initial assessment of the extensive scale of the challenge in their publication, WEO 2019, that is World Energy Outlook 2019. Two, their Energy Technology Perspective Series, ETP series, where the level of technology innovation required to reach the net zero emissions by 2050 were assessed. Three, in October 2020, another WEO 2020 was released, which focused on the crucial period of the next 10 years, that means 2021 we are in, to 2021 to 2030, the 10 years, exploring different ways out of this crisis. The new report provides the latest analysis of the COVID pandemic's impact and major steps to be taken through 2030, that means through these 10 years, including in terms of changes in consumer behavior. Four, on 18th May 2021, just a few weeks back, IEA published a very important document, Net Zero by 2050, a roadmap for the global energy sector. The United States, the European Union, and several major economies have recently pledged to reach net zero emissions by mid-century, that means 2050. Net zero does not mean countries would stop emitting carbon dioxide altogether. They would need to severely reduce most of the carbon dioxide generated by power plants, factories, and transport vehicles. The three main sources that release large amounts of gases into the atmosphere. And any emissions that could not be fully removed would be compensated by forests or by technologies that can pull carbon dioxide directly out of the atmosphere. To achieve net zero emissions, an extraordinary transformation of the global energy system is required. An extraordinary transformation of global energy system. Please note that. But many countries have not yet fully understood the extent of changes needed in the energy structure by 2050. IEA says every country would need to move much faster and more aggressively away from fossil fuels than they are currently doing. It means we have to adopt more and more of low carbon technologies such as solar, wind, biofuels, nuclear, and so on. For instance, the annual speed of installations for solar panels and wind turbines worldwide would have to increase fourfold by 2030. That means in 10 years from 2021-10, the installation of solar, wind, etc. has to be increased four times. Do you know what it means? It means the solar industry must build the equivalent of the present world's largest solar farm every day for the next 10 years. Yeah, that is the task ahead of the solar industry. However, the IEA, that is International Energy Agency, warned in April that global CO2 emissions were expected to rise at their second fastest pace ever in this year, 2021. You know why? As countries recovered from the after effects of the corona pandemic and global coal burning go up to a very high level, driven by a surge of industrial activity in the Asian countries. At a virtual summit of 40 world leaders that President Biden hosted in April, President Biden pledged to cut US greenhouse gas emissions at least 50% below 2005 levels by the end of this decade. That is 2030. Japan, Canada, and Britain, and the European Union promised steeper cuts, but you know, the largest emitters, China and India, along with Russia, did not commit any steeper cuts. Moreover, China and a few Asian economies have planned in 2020, that means last year, to add more new coal-fired power plants, though the Chinese president said his country would strictly limit increasing coal consumption in the next 5 years. There is some contradiction. What is being done, what is being said. And not only in China, and companies in the US and Canada are still targeting new oil and gas fields for development. Irrespective of these developments, IEA has offered a step-by-step guide for the world's governments who want to quickly change the course. Five steps. Number one, this year 2021, countries should stop approving new coal plants unless they are outfitted with carbon capture and storage technology to trap and bury the emissions underground. They would also stop approving the development of new oil and gas fields beyond those already committed. Number two, by 2025, that means in the next 5 years, governments worldwide would start banning the sale of new oil and gas furnaces to heat buildings and instead utilize cleaner electric heater pumps. Three, by 2030, that is in the next 10 years, 60% of new car sales globally would be electric, up from just 5% today, 5% to 60% in 10 years. By 2035, that means in 15 years, new gasoline or diesel-fueled passenger vehicles would not be sold. And by mid-century, 2050, virtually all cars worldwide either run on batteries or hydrogen. Number four, by 2035, that means in 15 years, the world's advanced economies would zero out emissions from power plants, shifting away from emitting coal and gas plants to technologies like wind, solar, nuclear, or carbon capture. By 2040, in 20 years, all of the world's remaining coal-fired power plants are closed or retrofitted with CCS technology. Number five, in 2035, that is in 15 years, more than half of the heavy trucks that move cargo would be electric. By 2040, in 20 years, roughly half of the air travel worldwide would be fueled by cleaner fuels such as sustainable biofuels or hydrogen instead of jet fuel. You see, the five talks, the time scales given are very tough, very tough. And to achieve energy transformation on this scale would require unprecedented global cooperation. The rich countries should help poorer countries where there is a lack of technological expertise and also lack of investment capital to decarbonize. Secondly, an exceptional research program, a crash research program, is required to improve cleaner energy technologies. Now, coming to investments, global power sector investment is set to increase by around 5% in 2021, that means this year. That means to more than $820 billion, its highest level, after staying almost flat last year in 2020. So it's a leap, giant leap in the investment in the power sector. The recovery in energy investment, this sort of investment, is a welcoming sign, and more of it flowing towards renewable energy sources is much more encouraging. But much greater sources have to be mobilized, and directed to clean energy technologies to put the world on track to reach net zero emissions by 2050. Based on IEA's net zero roadmap, which was released in last month, clean energy investment will need to triple in this decade. By 2030, the investment has to triple, then only what we said above could be possible. The IEA further says that the world can achieve enormous progress in reducing emissions over the next 10 years by deploying technologies that are already widely used, such as wind turbines and solar panels and electric vehicles. But roughly half the emissions cuts by 2050, that means by mid-century, would come from technologies that are still in the demonstration or prototype stage. What are they? One, cleaner hydrogen fuels for steel plants, advanced batteries to manage intermittent wind and solar output, and three, devices to pull carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere. A push for clean energy may create 30 million new jobs generally, but nearly 5 million people in fossil fuel industries could find themselves out of work. And today, worldwide, more than 785 million people have no access to electricity. What a bad situation. In 21st century, we still millions of people with no access to electricity. And the shift away from fossil fuels should not leave those people behind. That's very important. The current recovery packages and new climate policy measures suggested or announced may influence prospects of rising expenditure this year, that is 2021, on important areas like renewable power, electric grids, energy efficiency, and emerging technologies such as carbon capture, utilization and storage, and low carbon hydrogen. IEA concludes, limiting global warming to 1.5 degrees centigrade is technically, economically feasible, but there may be a little margin for error or maybe some delay. Making net zero emissions is a reality that hinges on a resolute focus from all governments working together with one another and with business, investors, and citizens. Remember, we have also a role in trying to cut down the emissions. You should understand that. Friends, this is what I like to say for this Environment Day. And before conclude, I advise, stay home, stay safe. If you have to go out, wear a mask, preferably 2 masks, maintain social distance. Staying safe is very important. Bye.